you the trade girl? Hi, do you have a Mew for a gold? What? It sounds like a terrible trade. And it really does sound like a terrible trade. But for those that don't know, you don't know how good this trade is. Because Golbat is what won us our first Pokemon Red. Nuzlocke. And yes, I get we had technically a Mew in that one too, but still, like, I mean, that's not a bad trade. That's not a bad trade. Hello, viewers. Welcome to the next episode of our Pokemon Red 50% boosted Nuzlocke. We're on episode, I believe, 6 now, and we took down Misty. We're going to be going forward, trying to maybe beat the SSN. I don't know if we'll get the third badge or not, but yeah, getting all the trainers in there. We got a level cap up, technically somewhere between 36 and 41. 41 being the most, 36 being, you know, what technically Lieutenant Surge will be at. So, we got a good couple levels here that we can kind of play around with a little bit. So, definitely exciting. As you can see, we do have the team before you with Zapdos, Blastoise, Meowth, Persian. Yes, I know I have technically two Meowth evolutions, but you know what? They're kind of different. One can try attack, the other one couldn't. So, you know, we had that going on. And Flareon and Charmander. So, yes, two fire types as well. But again, I don't mind. We got, you know, we got something. We got people, for sure. So here we are in Cerulean. Just have defeated Misty, all healed up, and going to make our way forward toward Lieutenant Surge. Hope you all are having a wonderful day. Be sure you do smash that like button, because it really does help out the video. And share with you in here. We love new faces, getting to talk to you all. So, definitely, you know, consider, you know, those options for free. So.
Hey, you. Stay up. It's not your hard, huh? I'm just an innocent bystander. Don't you believe me?
I mean, I kind of believe you guys. I kind of believe him. See, he's got a nice chin. Eradicate. Eradicate can be a little worrisome. He does have Super Fang, which can do a lot of damage. We're gonna try with Sean here and just kind of see. Hyper Fang. That might hurt too. No, he doesn't. Okay. So Super Fang's actually more worrisome than Hyper Fang right now. A couple water guns, and this guy will go down. I think we'll have to do three in total because, yes. You know, probably save some money on water gun. Bubbly, bubbly. We're at a level 30. Got basically 6 levels for him to kind of mess around with here. And you might be thinking, why did I just stay in with an Executor, or against an Executor with a water type? Well, don't worry, I'm not technically. I'm just switching to Vinny here to split the XP a little bit. That way, we're not too overpowering a certain Barrage will hit 3 whole times. We'll go for a super effective drill peck, which should probably destroy this Executor. I always have trouble spelling that Pokemon's name. I don't know about you guys, but I always struggle spelling Execute or Executor. But I think it's because I hear egg, and I expect, you know, that to start it instead of X, like EX. Oh. I need to make room for a TM. I thought I had, like, some terrible, so can't I just use this with that? Yeah. Maybe a little bit more drill packs. That should be still technically dig, I believe. I still kept on field move TMs, if I'm correct. Let me see here. It is still dig. So, technically, pretty much everybody will be able to learn this. I think, what, Flareon's the only one that's not able to? Who would benefit most from Big? Somebody that's weak against... So, maybe, what, Sean? Sean would be a good one, because he's weak to Electric. I think that'd be a good move, just in case. I know we don't really get stuck into things, but... At any point, having a diverse moveset is not a bad thing. But kind of keep our eye on our bag a little bit since we are getting a little high. But we do have a new encounter down here, and actually before we get too far down, we're good on balls. Oh yeah, we have like 30 balls, we're fine. We do get a new encounter down here. What do I think it'll be? I think we are needing a... I was going to say Psychic. Or Alakazam, or, you know, any of those overpowered. That would be a good random one to say. Ice would be a good one. Like a Dewgong. Well, I guess we have water. I don't know. Just something different. starter squad. Yo, are we about to have all three of the starters? I mean, I know we didn't technically, like, focus on Squirtle, whatever type of deal, but still, like, having the evolutionary lines is actually not too bad. This thing is actually a decent level, though. I'm gonna go up to Vinny just so I can eat some of this hits. Now, I might have, like, Sleep Powder, all those annoying moves. Yeah, I predicted that. I'm gonna go for Thundershock. It should not kill. A bit more damage than I hoped. As long as we don't get a crit here. Oh, actually, Lead Seed will actually help it out a little bit here. No crit, and we will catch Ivysaur. Why did I feel like that one did less? And we'll see if he gives a little bit more health back, and then we will attempt another attack. For now, we're going to try tossing a ball and see if we can catch Mr. Ivysaur. Ivysaur's great. I don't know if it's because it's standing up and just makes it weird standing up or what, but it's just off to me by a cousin standing up. Can we get a para? That'd be pretty cool. We do not get a para. How much is poison doing to me, by the way? About 5. And then Leech Seed does about the same too. So, okay. Gotta just keep an eye on that. We do have potions, we have antidotes, all that good stuff, so we'll be fine. And we get the triple wiggle, which means we get Mr. Ivysaur. We're gonna go to a nicknames here. If you guys did not know, if you're subscribed here, leave comments, anything like that, you guys definitely get nicknamed after Pokemon here. So, we're gonna go ahead and look at my little list here. And actually, you know what? This one's technically kind of claimed. This is gonna be nicknamed after Jonesy. Favorite Pokemon's Bulbasaur. So I feel like the Bulbasaur line is a good fit for him. So, we're gonna go ahead and antidote our Vinny. And then Ivysaur will go to the box, which we might take him out depending. We could also put something in the daycare for a bit. I'll debate on that maybe later on. Definitely with, like, the fossil Pokemon and stuff, that might not be a bad idea. And are you the trade girl? Hi, do you have a Mew for a goal? What? It sounds like a terrible trade. It really does sound like a terrible trade. But for those that don't know, you don't know how good this trade is. Because Golbat is what won us our first Pokemon Red. Nuzlocke. And yes, I get we had technically a Mew in that one too, but still, like, I mean, that's not a bad trade. That's not a bad trade. Is it a great trade? Probably a little bit, but either way, I know also there's, like, hidden items through here. I'm not too concerned with that, to be honest with you. Let's just keep moving forward and see what other possible encounters we can get, and get some bits of grinding. I know also there's some hidden items up here somewhere. Now, don't mind me as I kind of mash the A button a little bit. Because I thought they're, like, directly in the middle, but maybe I'm completely wrong. There's hidden items here, right? Guys, I just lost everything. Okay, if this one isn't here, then I'm just assuming you just always need the item finder to find the hidden items. Need, like, the item finder, or am I just being completely stupid? Maybe we need the item finder. I don't know. We'll figure it out. For now, we'll keep pressing forward as I look like a little bit stuck. We're trying to pull that out. Since there's not many bug Pokemon here, we will see if we can prove them wrong. We got a Moltres, level 24. Still not. I probably should research which one's stronger, Bubble or Water Gun. My gut says it's Water Gun. I feel like it's Bubble, Water Gun, Bubble Beam, if my memory is serving me correctly. But I might be wrong. Fire Spin. That's kind of like crap in this generation, so that is a little annoying. Now, we'll just go ahead and let these turns run down. Take down the Moltres. Porygon, the band of Pokemon.
He didn't do anything wrong, guys.
I mean, he was in the episode, but still,
didn't do anything.
Conversion, what type are you going to become? Water type. So, Bite is the right move here. Psy Beam. That can confuse me, right? I guess it wasn't crit, but that can do some decent damage. Good job for you. Slowpoke's coming in. Really need to train up some of the rest of the team, because you can see now, like, Sean and Vinny are definitely our aces with being level 30 and 33, but the next closest is 60. And seeing we need to be around 36, might not be too bad if we get, like, at least one of them up there. Maybe, like, mid-20s. Hopefully we can get some, like, good grass types, or, I don't know, really, for Meowth and Persian, but just something that's not super effective against them that they can train against. That would probably help. Take on this, I'm gonna assume couple. Or maybe just two friends chitty-chatting. Ooh, Pidgeot. I love Pidgeot. One of my favorite Pokemon, honestly. I definitely need to heal here soon, by the way. Health is not looking the best. Rowan, I will not be affected. Sand attack fails, and quick attack is a smart move, it's a good stab. Sean grows to level 31. I'm trying to learn withdrawal. I don't really feel like it now. Those type of set of moves aren't really the best. Anything but special attack boost or attack boost are pretty much the best. Sometimes leers and stuff like that can come in handy, but yeah, otherwise. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and speed up this healing process. So I apologize. But it just helps us. Excuse me. Oh, she says, I'm gonna say the exact same sentence as him. Two Pokemon. Nidorina. This one's kind of like the reverse of Ivysaur. Like, I'm used to that one kind of more standing up than I am on all fours, even though this is technically the original sprite. Same with Ivysaur, technically. That was what the original saw was him standing up, and then he became on all fours. Arena kind of got the reverse treatment. Ooh, a Lapras. Whenever you switch into something and then just switch out. Let me go to my weakest Pokemon and then just switch to Vinny. Now, this thing probably has Ice Beam, which is really worrisome, but if it starts using that, we will switch out. We take it down anyway. Vinny gets all the way up to level 9. I do like it doesn't do like level 6, level 7, level 8. I do like it just jumps to the level you get to in Gen 1. It's probably one of its best mechanics. It just skips right to whatever you're going to be. Also, we'll have to kind of see what the encounter is here, too, and we could also potentially move team members around that are weaker for those stronger mons, as well. Hello, my champ. I'm actually a little worrisome. You have, like, good moves and stuff, so, oh god. Is that just 30? Is that full health? I don't even know. This could actually be probably some of these sets of leers. I'm gonna go to Vinny and just drill pick it, so it dies. We have two trainers left, and then still the encounter. We got a lot of encounters. We have this, Vermilion, Diglett's Cave, and the Route to the Ring. So, a lot of encounters to potentially move around in the team here. It's really hard for me sometimes to change teams around, just because I get sometimes attached to my beginning members, but at the same point, if it makes logistic sense, why not? Okay, Batty is definitely a it's definitely a problem, but we should outspeed it, get some good damage off. It's a glass cannon, so that's a little annoying, so ooh, we don't have a lot of answers for a lot of types. Golem. Or just grass types are just utterly abundant, and rock types and things will bet. Meowth and Persian can't touch are just nowhere to be found. See, Mankey technically has fighting type moves. So he kind of scares me. What level is that? 24? Yeah, I just don't trust Charmander being able to handle that. Alright, last trainer. We'll go heal, and then we will get our next encounter. Hopefully something exciting. The encounter is kind of exciting. Wait, Metapod. Now we have Ember on you. Yes, we do. Hopefully he only has Harden. Kind of scared actually a little bit, but gotta risk it for the XP. Hopefully Ember special, so these Hardens literally do not matter. Now we'll go to the level 24 Metapod. How much experience will that give me as a player? Would've got me a lot more if I just stayed in, but Alakazam's coming in. I think we just need to hit this as hard as we can. So we're just gonna go for a stab drill peck. I think that's the best play here. This thing is weak at the knees. Bike voucher here. There's so much actually to do in Lieutenant Surge's town, which I'm excited for. Right up there with Erica's town with like most exciting things to get. Like I said, you have all those encounters I just mentioned and the bike voucher, get on the boat, all that great stuff you get cut. Erica's town, you got the big mart, the static Eevee, two encounters actually, and obviously Erica herself, Team Rocket. A lot of the tea or drink, whatever, stations there. Alright, let's get my encounter here. This is dupes, obviously, because of, Ivysaur. So, I think I'm gonna go ahead and re-encounter. I did consider it for a second, but I was just like, why? When I probably won't have Venusaur too long from now with the fact that I have Ivysaur. Get an encounter, please. Alright, we got a Fearow, flying type, which we do not have. Let's go for Bubble. That shouldn't kill this Fearow. Yeah, we can go for one more of those. Lower its speed. I don't know if I've ever actually used a Fearow before. Not a Fearow before, but I don't know if I've ever actually used one. Keep level 20. Decent Pokemon, normal flying type. And we're gonna go ahead and name this. Name this after Ethan. So we can get the next encounter, and like I said, after we get all the encounters and everything, we can kind of consider about switching the team around if we want. Alright, so let's go to item, rod. Wait, where you can't register in this game. Got a bite, and it's going to be... Ooh, a Marowak. I'll gladly take a Marowak. Not hit this thing with Blastoise, sadly. Really, actually, my version might be a good play here. Staff in there, but actually, it does a lot of damage to me. Okay, maybe version isn't the right play here. Bailey, are you a better play? You're basically a version, just, you know, different. Okay, so we got him pretty weak. It's kind of hard to catch. Getting hit. I don't have anything to put status on it, which is why I think Ivysaur wouldn't be a bad addition, because it'd give us a status mod. Hey, we got the Marowak. Now, let me think of a good nickname for Marowak. Do it after Thomas. sell, not really. Eventually I will have to start using the Pokemon PC for storage and stuff like that, but I won't worry about it just yet. Let's get our Diglett cave encounter really quick. Ooh, a Dragonair. Actually, that's a pretty good addition. Dragon type's not obviously common. There's literally only one in this game. My one weakness being ice. I think this would be a really good addition to us. We can end up doing some stuff to it. Okay, so yeah, water gun just doesn't cut it here. How much does fight do? Okay, that's a good amount there. I'm gonna start going for bubble just to be on the safe side. Paralyzes me. I think that's weak. I think that's technically red for him. I think this has a hard catch rate being a pseudo. It does have Thunder Wave status as well. Like we were talking about Ivysaur, this would be another one that could get status. I don't remember if Twister exists in this generation. I think it's the only Dragon Rage, isn't it? The only Dragon move in this game. Here, and like I said, I try to keep these between 15 and 20, at the extreme of 30, but I'm also going to open encounter. Anything I could do to help me catch this more than what I'm doing. I'm just going to speed up and use these balls really quick. Six more, five more, four more, and I caught it with four left. Okay. I did use a lot of my balls, but this is actually a really good encounter. Not looking here, sorry. I'm gonna name this after Zach. I think this is how you spell it. Could be with an H, but so I apologize. We go ahead and quickly heal before we make further progress. I think isn't there also a trade in this town as well? If you am correct in saying that, but I thought there was a far-fetch trade in this town. Might be a different town. I think we definitely probably will have some team layout changes, but I'll probably do that in between episodes, if that makes sense. You have a Tentacruel for Psyduck. I mean, I guess it's not horrible. Let me go ahead and grab the bike vouchers just so I know that's done. We'll grab that on the way to Erica. Who else talking about is Rapidash. Who else's his favorite Pokemon's Rapidash? I want to know. I know there's people out there. Oh wait, I didn't get the bike. Because my thing is full. Poison Sting. It's just that. I know I can sell that, but same point. Should get a lot of money over this game. So, let me go ahead and just. Get this last encounter, and that's where we will for sure wrap up. But we have all the encounters done. I know there's technically some considered the path between the SSN as a new area as well. I don't know, because technically all Magikarps are going to be probably Marowak, so I doubt we're going to just accept that until we either get a Rod or Surf. And I think at that point we can't access that area. Which Dragonair again? We could get two of them, but why not call dupes and see what else is here? Song. I was literally talking about you as I'm reading this episode. I don't remember when, but I know I did. I'm sure I did. Oh, well, crit. Oh, okay. I guess I didn't really want to go. I didn't want to. Oh. I got the water type. All that good stuff with Mr. two cannons over here. So, I think this is a good place to ribbity wrap it up. I feel like I always wrap it up in the Pokemon Center. So you know what? I'm going to change things up. I am going to still heal so I know it's done. But I'm going to wrap up, where you guys are. Right here from this lovely waterfront between us. But thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure you just smash that like button and subscribe if you are new. Other than that, guys, we will see you in other video streams, whatever it may be. Thank you always for hanging out with me. Other than that, guys, where I said, we're going to go ahead and wrap up. I'll see you in the next video stream, whatever. Our gaming.